Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, a professor of mechanical engineering at Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through this video lecture series on heat and mass transfer. And today we are going to discuss on the heat exchanger, lecture number 4. The topic for today's discussion is problems on effectiveness NTU method. We'll recap from the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we discussed the effectiveness NTU method. We defined the effectiveness, which is actual heat transfer divided by maximum possible heat transfer. We defined NTU, number of transfer unit, which is UA by C minimum. And based on the procedure, there are two types of problem in the effectiveness NTU method. One is a rating problem, another one is sizing problem. So based on the theory what we studied earlier lecture, we are going to solve problems here. And at the end of the lecture, learning outcome for the students. So the students, you will be able to solve problems in effectiveness NTU method on your own. We take the first example. A parallel flow heat exchanger has hot and the cold water stream running through it. The flow rate are 10 and 25 kilograms per minute respectively. The inlet temperature are 75 degrees Celsius and 25 degrees Celsius for hot and the cold side. The exit temperature of the hot side should not exceed 50 degrees Celsius. Assume HI equal to HO equal to 600 watts per meter square Kelvin. Calculate the area of heat exchanger using effectiveness NTU method. So based on the problem, read the problem carefully and write down the given data. So mass of the hot water is 10 kilograms per minute, which is 0.17 kilograms per second. Mass of the cold water is 25 kilograms per minute, which is 0.42 kilograms per second. Hot water inlet temperature is 75 degrees Celsius. Cold water inlet temperature is 25 degrees Celsius and hot water outlet temperature is 50 degrees Celsius. The conductive heat transfer coefficient at the inside and the outside of the heat exchanger pipe, which is 600 watts per meter square Kelvin. Now the specific heat of the hot water at the mean temperature, mean temperature of the hot water is 75 plus 50 divided by 2, which is 62.5 degrees Celsius. So at this temperature, from the heat and mass transfer data book, we take the specific heat of the hot water, which is 4196.5 joules per kilogram Kelvin, and you take the specific heat of the cold water. So the cold water inlet temperature is given as 25 degrees Celsius. You take the CPC as 4178 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And the first step, you have to calculate the heat capacities. Heat capacity of the cold fluid, MCCPC, which is 0.42 into 4178, which is 1754.76 watts per Kelvin, CH equal to MHCPH, which is 0.17 into 4196.5, which is 713.4 watts per Kelvin. And the ratio of the heat capacities, C equal to C minimum by C maximum, so which is 713.4 divided by 1754.76 equals 0.41. The effectiveness of heat exchanger, epsilon equal to CH by THI minus THO divided by C minimum by into THI minus TCI. So the numerator is the actual heat transfer based on the data of the hot water, and the denominator is the maximum possible heat transfer, which is C minimum into THI minus TCI. So substituting 713.4, CH equal to 713.4 into 75 minus 50 divided by C minimum equal to 713.4 into 75 minus 25, which is 0.5. And using the effectiveness NTU chart, page number 163 of your heat and mass transfer data book, for a parallel flow heat exchanger at epsilon equal to 0.5 and C equal to 0.41, the number of transfer unit NTU equal to 0.81. So this data we have to obtain from the heat and mass transfer data book from page number 163. The overall heat transfer coefficient, 1 by U equal to 1 by HI plus 1 by HO, simplifying, we'll get a U equal to 300 watts per meter square Kelvin. Now the heat transfer area required, A equal to NTU into C minimum divided by U. which is 0.81 into 703.4 divided by u equal to 300, which is 1.93 meter square. So the area required for the parallel flow heat exchanger is 1.93 meter square. This is the answer. And the example number 2, it is desired to use double pipe counter flow heat exchanger to cool 3 kg of oil of CP 2.1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin from 120 degree Celsius. The cooling water at 20 degree Celsius enters the heat exchanger at a rate of 10 kilograms per second. The overall heat transfer coefficient of the heat exchanger is 600 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the heat transfer area is 6 meter square. Calculate this exit temperature of the oil and the water. After reading the problem, you write down the given data. So the mass of the hot oil is 3 kilograms per second, and specific heat of the oil is 2100 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The inlet temperature of the oil is 120 degree Celsius. The inlet temperature of the water is 20 degree Celsius, and the mass of the cooling water is 10 kilograms per second. Overall heat transfer coefficient is 600 watts per meter square Kelvin. Area of the heat exchanger is 6 meter square. Now we have to take the specific heat of the water as 4178 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And heat capacity of the two fluids, heat capacity of the cold water CC equal to MC CPC, which is 10 into 4178, 41780 watts per Kelvin. And specific is heat capacity of the hot oil, which is MHCPH, 3 into 2100, which is 6300 watts per Kelvin. The ratio of heat capacities, C equal to C minimum by C maximum, which is 6300 divided by 41780, which is 0.15. And now we have to calculate the number of transfer unit, NTU equal to UA by C minimum, 600 into 6 divided by 6300, which is 0.57. From the effectiveness chart, page number 164, for counter flow heat exchanger, at C equal to 0.15 and NTU equal to 0.57, the effectiveness is found to be 0.42. Now the heat transfer rate, Q equal to epsilon into C minimum in THI minus TCA, which is 0.42 into 6300 into 120 minus 20 equal to 264,600 watts. And the exit temperature of the oil and the cooling water, so THO equal to THI minus Q by CH, which is 120 divided by 264,600 divided by 6300, which is 678 degrees Celsius, and TCO equal to TCI plus Q by CC, which is equal to 20 plus 264,600 divided by 41,780, which is 26.3 degrees Celsius. This is the answer for the problem. The hot water outlet temperature, hot oil outlet temperature is 70 degrees Celsius, and the cold water outlet temperature is 26.3 degrees Celsius. And example number 3, hot gases enters a cross flow heat exchanger at 300 degrees Celsius and leaves at 100 degrees Celsius are used to heat water at a flow rate of 1 kilograms per second from 35 degrees Celsius to 125 degrees Celsius. The exhaust gas specific heat is approximately 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin, and overall heat transfer coefficient is 100 watts per meter square Kelvin. Calculate the heat transfer area required using effectiveness NT method. Take the specific heat of water as 4197 joules per kilogram Kelvin and the exhaust gases as 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from the problem, the given data are specific heat of the hot gases, it is 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The hot gases inlet temperature is 300 degrees Celsius and the exit temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. The cold water inlet temperature is 35 degrees Celsius and outlet temperature is 125 degrees Celsius. The mass of the cold water is 1 kilograms per second. Overall heat transfer coefficient is 100 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the specific heat of the water is taken as 4197 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And the rate of heat transfer is equal to rate heat gained by the water, the Q equal to MC, CPC, TCO minus TCI, which is 4197, 1 into 4197 into 125 minus 35, which is 377,730 watts. The mass flow rate of the hot gas is, so MH equal to Q divided by M, CPH into THI minus THO, which is 1.9 kilograms per second. Now the heat capacity of the two fluid, heat capacity of the cold water and the hot gases, CC equal to MC CPC, which is 4197 watts per Kelvin, and CH equal to 1.9 into 1000, which is 1900 watts per Kelvin. And ratio of the heat capacities, C equal to C minimum by C maximum, which is 1900 divided by 4197, which is 0.45. The effectiveness of the heat exchanger, CH into THI minus THO divided by C minimum into THI minus TCI. So the 1900 is the CH value into 300 minus 100 divided by 1900 is the C minimum value into 300 minus 35, which is 0.75. Now from the effectiveness NTU chart for a cross flow heat exchanger, both the fluid unmixed, page number 166, effectiveness equal to 0.75 and C equal to 0.45, NTU is 2. So you have to take this value from the chart, page number 166. And from the NTU value, we calculate the area. So area equal to NTU into C minimum divided by U, which is equal to 2 into 1900 divided by 100 equal to 38 meters square. This is the area for the heat exchanger. Answer to the problem is 38 meters square. In example number 4, hot gases enters a finned tube cross flow heat exchanger with a flow rate of 1.5 kilograms per second and a temperature of 250 degrees Celsius. The gases are used to heat water entering the heat exchanger flow rate 1 kilograms per second with the inlet temperature of 35 degrees Celsius. On the gas side, the overall heat transfer coefficient is 100 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the area is 40 meter square. What is the rate of heat transfer by the heat exchanger and what is the gas and the water exit temperature? Assume CP of the gas as 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So the given data are mass of the hot gases are 1.5 kilograms per second. A specific heat of the hot gases are 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin, and hot gases inlet temperature is 250 degrees Celsius. Cold water inlet temperature is 35 degrees Celsius. Mass of the cold water is 1 kilograms per second. Overall heat transfer coefficient is 100 watts per meter square Kelvin. The heat transfer area is 40 meter square. And we take the specific heat of the water as 4180 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And we calculate the heat capacity of the fluid. Heat capacity of the cold water CC equal to MC CPC, 1 into 4180 equal to 4180. And specific heat of the hot gases, MHCPH equal to 1.5 into 1000, which is 1500 watts per Kelvin. And ratio of the heat capacities, C minimum by C maximum, 1500 divided by 4180 equal to 0.36. And number of transfer unit, UA by C minimum, which is 100 into A 40 divided by 1500, which is 2.7. And from the effectiveness NTU chart, for cross flow heat exchanger, both fluid unmixed, NTU equal to 2.7, and NTU equal to 2.7 and C equal to 0.36, the effectiveness of the heat exchanger equal to 0.84. And the heat transfer, once you know the effectiveness value, rate of heat transfer Q equal to epsilon into C minimum THA minus TCI, which is 0.84 into 1500 into 250 minus 35 equal to 270,900 watts. Then exit temperature of the hot and the cold, hot gas and the cold water are THO equal to THI minus Q by CH, which is 250 minus 270,900 divided by 1500, which is 69.4 degrees Celsius, and TCO equal to TCI plus Q by CC, which is 35 plus 270,900 divided by 4180, which is 99.8 degrees Celsius. The hot gas outlet temperature is 69.4 degrees Celsius. The cold water outlet temperature is 99.8 degree Celsius. We take another example, example number 5, an oil flow of 20.15 kilograms per second at a temperature of 122 degree Celsius is to be cooled by counterflow heat exchanger using 5.04 kilograms per second of water initially at 10 degree Celsius. The heat exchanger contains 200 tubes of 4.87 meter long and 1.97 centimeter outer diameter. Overall heat transfer coefficient is 340 watts per meter square Kelvin and specific heat of the oil is 2.094 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Calculate the exit temperature of the oil and the water. And from the data, mass of the oil is 20.15 kilograms per second. Specific heat of the oil is 2094 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Temperature of oil at inlet 121 degree Celsius. Temperature of water at the inlet 10 degree Celsius. Mass of the water is 5.04 kilograms per second. Overall heat transfer coefficient is 340 watts per meter square Kelvin. N equal to 200, number of tubes equal to 200. L equal to 4.87 meter. And diameter D equal to 0.0197 meter. And we take the specific heat of the water as 4178 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So here we calculate the heat transfer capacity of the fluid. Cc equal to MCCPC into 5.04 into 4178 equal to 21057.12 watts per Kelvin. And Ch of the oil is MHCPH equal to 20.15 into 2094. 42,194 watts per Kelvin. Then ratio of the heat capacities, we calculate C minimum by C maximum as 21,057.12 divided by 42,124, which is 0.5. The area of the heat exchanger now, number of tubes into surface area, N into pi dL, so 200 into pi into 0.0197 into 4.87, which is 60.23 meter square. Number of transfer unit NT equal to UA by C minimum, which is 6340 into 60.23 divided by 21,057.12, which is 0.97. From the effectiveness NTU chart, page number 164 for counterflow heat exchanger, NT equal to 0.97 and C equal to 0.5, the effectiveness is found to be 0.57. From the effectiveness, we calculate the heat transfer Q equal to epsilon into C minimum into THI minus TCI, which is equal to 0.57 into 21,057.12 into 121 minus 10 equal to 1.33 in 10 power 6 watts. That is what the actual amount of heat transfer. Then the exit temperature of the water and the hot gases, THO equal to THI minus Q by CH, which is 121. Minus 1.33 in 10 power 6 divided by 42,194.1, which is 89.35, and TCO equal to TCI plus Q by CC, which is 10 plus 1.33 in 10 power 6 divided by 21,057.12 equal to 73.16 degree Celsius. And these are all the reference book what I referred for the discussion. You can reach to the book and refer for further information. And this is what the book I published earlier in the heat transfer. You can refer to it. And if any queries, you can write to me to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer to the queries. So thank you. We'll meet again.